this movie called?
About 2 hours and 15 minutes later.
That was the best, worst movie ever!
What did you say?
You said, Jesus, what? What do you mean the movie was bad? It was the great movie ever!
Okay, well if it was so great then, why don't you tell me what it's about? Because I didn't understand any of it.
What do you mean you didn't understand the whole movie? Can't you see, like, the Soviets wanted to destroy, like, the whole of America? Then Remus, he tried to defend, and the CIA guy tried to help him. Are you following me?
Alright, so yeah, Ramius, the captain of the Red October, the submarine. He was trying to defect to the United States. And then Jack, the CIA agent over in America, in the USA, he tried to help Ramius defect, right?
Yeah, so like once the Soviets figured out Ramius was going to defect, they sent out their entire fleet. And once the United States saw this, they like were kind of uneasy because like they saw it as a threat, so... So Jack went out to the middle of the ocean to find the USS Dallas, which was actually tracking the Red October at the time, so he could try to communicate to Ramius on the Red October.
Yeah, that's true. Like, when Ramius and the CIA guy, they tried to make a plan on how they can escape. Yeah, that's true. Actually, they made their plan awesome because they were trying to hit the Red October from the Soviets who are throwing the turbines.
Yeah, and right at the last second, another Soviet submarine, the Alpha, it was called, right? They came in and they tried to destroy the Red October, so they shot like a missile at it, but then the Red October dodged it, and Dallas came in and did all that anti-missile stuff, and then that Soviet submarine blew itself up, right?
Yeah, they escaped to me. It was a happy ending. The Red October was safe and everything was good. You get it now?
Yeah, I guess I get it. But it's still not that great of a movie. You know what I'm talking about, Matt?
Yeah, I don't know.
What the heck are you talking about? Matt thought it was a great movie, right, Matt?
Yeah, I thought it was okay. I really did like how it was a lot of fiction, but it really showed how the conflict between the Soviets and the Americans at that time was pretty intense, and like situations like that, even like especially in the Cuban Missile Crisis, could lead to really bad things happening.
Yeah, but I mean, the movie wasn't really that accurate.
I mean, it was based off a fictional book.
It wasn't that movie.
Well, you see, I mean, it was based on fiction, but I'd say the setting of the movie was pretty real, I mean.
You're talking about the relations between the Soviets and the USA, right?
Yeah, right. I mean, that seems very realistic to me.
Yeah, the movie does show the tensions that we learned in class about the Soviets and the US. Yeah, it does show all the tensions, right?
Yeah, during the Cold War. Yeah. You got a good point there, Dennis. But I'm still not feeling it. I mean, it was, honestly, the entire movie, it didn't happen. It was just fiction. I gotta say that. I'm really sorry.
Yeah, imagine if like the Americans actually took like the Soviets' like biggest technological advancement in like military weaponry. What would happen?
Yeah, it's not ever gonna happen. That's not gonna happen.
Yeah, it doesn't seem likely.
Not gonna happen.
Yeah, that's just...
Dennis, that movie. Yeah. The movie is unrealistic. Mm. Very unrealistic. I'm glad you're agreeing with me.
Yeah.
It might seem unrealistic, but I mean, I think overall it's a really good movie.
Really? Honestly?
I think I might.
You're siding with that kid over there.
I would suggest that.
Seriously? This makes me upset. I'm gonna go outside, I'm gonna stick my head in the freezer. Thank you very much. I'm gonna go do that. Get out of my way, kid. Alright? Yeah, alright? It's freezer time.
Brandon, what are you doing, man? Brandon, what are you doing?
I'm just kind of trying to calm down, alright?
It's all. It's okay, man. It's
just
Yeah.
You know what, you guys are right. It's just a movie. Nothing to get worried of. Terrible movie, but it's okay.
I thought it was good.
Yeah, that's back inside. Still think it's a terrible movie though.
It was good!
What?
Red October was a very good movie. It really portrayed a lot of Cold War conflicts, and I suggest you all go see that because it was really fun. It was a good movie.
Well, I, on the other hand, I mean, I would recommend it to you if you like a good summary movie, but if you're really looking for something that has to do with real history, I wouldn't watch this if I were you. But if you like submarines, go ahead and watch it because it's got submarines in it, but it's not very historically accurate, except for the whole Soviet Union Cold War tensions nonsense.
Yeah, I would say the movie was fine, and it had some pretty good action in it that it brought the fun of the whole, like, historical events. When you're watching the movie, it's kind of fun to watch, and it does explain most of the historical facts. It's a nice movie, actually.
Well, there you have it. I'm Brendan Perdikas, that is Matt Somebody, and that is Dennis, and you were not watching The View.
Thanks for coming over, just gonna... No
problem, man. Thanks for having us.
All right, yeah. Okay, yes. All right, get out there, guys. All right, hey. Next time, we're watching Pearl Harbor.
All right.
Oh, that's right. Let's go.
All right, I get out of my house. Go.